In this session, we will control a hardware timer to make the basic LED, which we often use, turn on and off every second. We open the code from last time, and here we will clear the code and start with from sin to pin. For now, we will just set the pin to 25. As the LED pin. If we want to turn it off and on every second, typically, we would use front time, volt, sleep, and then a while, loop. This will include LED, toggle, which changes the LED from low to high, and from high to low. We will execute this and write the code to do this every second. But let me simply show you how to do it with a hardware timer. Instead of that, let's delve into the details of the timer setup process. First, we need to initialize the timer, which is a crucial step in ensuring that our timing operations are accurate and reliable. The period for the timer is specified in milliseconds, allowing for precise control over the timing intervals. The mode we are using is called timer, dip, periodic, which is one of several modes available. Each mode has its own specific use cases and advantages. In this session, we will configure the timer to execute repeatedly every second, which is ideal for tasks that require regular intervals. However, if your requirement is for the timer to execute just once after 1 second and then automatically turn off, you can input one shot here. The one-shot mode is particularly useful for single-event timing operations. Moving on to the fallback mechanism, you have the flexibility to name the function whatever you like, but for the sake of this example, I will set it to timeout. The fallback function is essential as it defines the action to be taken when the timer completes its Q cycle. Then, if the timeout function is triggered, the variable t will receive the timer instance, allowing you to handle the timer event programmatically. This setup is versatile and can be adapted to a wide range of applications, from simple delays to complex scheduling tasks. Here, we won't need to use LED toggle like this. The timer is within the machine module, and for hardware timer control, we initialize the timer, then declare the instance. When executing the init function of the instance, we set the period to 1 second in milliseconds and the mode to periodic. If we want it to execute just once, we set it to one shot. Then we specify the function name in the callback, which I have set to timeout. This means that this function will execute every second, and each time LED.toggle will run, causing the LED to turn on and off every second. Let's check it out. The hardware timer is currently running, and as you can see, the basic LED is turning on and off every second. In this session, we explored controlling a hardware timer using MicroPython. I will definitely see you very soon next time with another topic.